March 1st, 2010. Tiana Botello calls 911 after her parents are shot.
Monday, 3-1-2010 at 8:50 p.m.
Emergency 911, what's the problem?
My mommy's in the basement, and I need emergency, and I need hello.
Where at?
I'm at, and I'll go ask my mommy. Mommy, I'll tell you where we at. I'll tell you, I need.
Let me speak to your mom.
No, she's almost dead. Mommy, where are we at? Tell me, I got the police on the phone. Tell me. Mommy, tell me. Where are we at? Where we at? We should wait. I called 911. Where are we at? Where are we at? I'm outside, and
let me speak to your mom.
I don't know who he is.
Okay, call your mom on the phone if she's there.
She's almost dead, please.
Okay, you need. I can't help you without you helping me. Let me see who else in the house.
Nobody's else in the house.
Okay, you need to give me an address. You need to calm down and give me an address. I don't know where you're at. You have to give me an address.
Address?
Yes. Hello? Yes. Stop screaming.
My mommy's almost dead.
Okay, ma'am. I need you to calm down and give me a location.
Please help me. You promise you'll help me?
I'm going to help you once you help me, okay? Go on the porch. Can you open up the door?
No.
Do you see any mail?
No. I can tell you the address.
What's the address?
If I can find it, it is, I don't see it, but I'm trying to look.
Okay, calm down.
Okay.
Is there any mail on the table or in a drawer? How old are you?
I'm 8 years old.
Do you see any mail on the table or any mail in the drawer?
No.
Do you see any mail on your mom's dresser?
My mom doesn't live here.
Okay, you were just screaming at your mom. Who do you live with?
Huh?
Who do you live with?
I live with my mother.
Your mother?
Yes.
Look on her dresser. You just said your mom don't live there.
Yeah, but I'm looking for everything, and I can't find anything. Please. She's almost dead.
Okay, you need to calm down and find me something with an address. I can't help you without an address.
Okay, I'll try to look outside again.
Open up the door and look at the porch, up on the porch. Open up the door. Look on the porch. Give me those numbers off your porch.
All right.
You said no one else is there. I hear someone in the back.
Oh, that's my sister.
Okay, how old is your sister?
Okay, I know the address now.
How old is your sister?
She's 6. I know the address now. 19380.
What is the street?
I can tell you, this, but it's...
You have to tell me the street.
Okay, it's G-L-A, I don't know what it's called.
Glastonbury?
Yes.
Is this a house or is this a two-family flat?
It's a house.
What is wrong with your mom?
She got shot.
Somebody shot her?
Yes.
Who shot your mom?
I don't know. Somebody.
Where is your mom at?
She's downstairs in the basement.
Who is the guy?
I don't know. She was just some guy.
And she's bleeding from where?
Yes, she's bleeding from, I don't know, from her head or something. I think it's on my head.
Okay, I request the police and EMS.
She's still breathing. My dad is not.
Your dad? Let me speak to your dad.
No, he's dead. My mom is still breathing.
So your mom and dad were shot?
Yes. Hello, and I need emergency, okay? Hello?
Detroit, Michigan. Monica Bartello and her daughters, ages 8 and 6, went to visit her boyfriend, Purcell Carson, at his home. The night of the murders, there were no signs of a forced entry. Two men named Derek Smith and Debbie Smith were at Purcell's home to complete a drug deal. When the money was being counted, Debbie and Derek pulled out guns. Debbie ordered Monica to go to the bathroom with her daughters at gunpoint, but changed his mind and took Monica out. They used duct tape to bound Monica and Purcell's wrists. Purcell started to beg for his life and begged them not to kill him because he had a family. The two men forced Monica and Purcell down to the basement. The men duct taped both of their mouths and made them lay across a couch. Monica was shot once in the back of her head and Purcell was shot once in the front of his. When the killers left, 8-year-old Tiana called 911 from her mother's cell phone. Investigators said that Purcell knew Derek from prison. They were in the same lockup for a drug conviction. Derek had a criminal record that included weapon charges, kidnapping, armed robbery, and assault since 1986, and he was released from prison in 2007. Debbie did admit he was in the house, but said he did nothing to aid Derek that night. He said Derek was the person responsible for the robbing, binding, and murders. He said Derek called him about a drug deal, but once he saw the robbery going on, he took the kids to the bathroom for protection and left. There was an outcry about how the 911 dispatcher handled the call when it got released to the public since it was a child and the situation she was in. The dispatcher was accused of hanging up on Tiana and not being sympathetic to her. They said she was cold-hearted. Police Chief Warren Evans said the dispatcher acted appropriately by sending a car in a timely fashion, but she could have shown more sensitivity toward Tiana since she found her parents murdered. They wouldn't release the dispatcher's name or exactly how she got disciplined because it was a personnel matter. The 911 recording was released with permission from Bartello's family to show the distress and agony her young daughter experienced while making the call and to get the public's righteous indignation of what kind of guy we're looking for here, the chief said. This dispatcher in that case did everything right, I mean everything but demeanor. Derek Smith was found later in California and arrested. He was convicted of 2 counts of first-degree murder, 2 counts of torture. He was also sentenced as a fourth habitual offender and given concurrent sentences of life in prison with no chance of parole and 60 to 90 years for the torture. Debbie Smith was arrested 6 months after the crime. He was tried twice since the jury couldn't reach a verdict on his charges during the first trial. He was convicted of 2 counts of torture, 2 counts of first-degree murder, and possession of a firearm during the commission of a felony. He was sentenced to life for the murders, 23 to 50 for the tortures, and a consecutive 2 years for the firearm conviction.